Hello everyone and welcome to This Is Football. As you guys know, I don't usually do pre-recorded videos. I usually go live, we have a lot of interactions in the comment section and we have a good time together. But today I planned on doing something different because this is something that's perpetuated by the media. A lot of fan bases speak on it and try to use it against the best right back on earth. So today's discussion will be Trent can actually defend and him not being able to defend is simply a myth, and today we are going to be dispelling that myth together. So first of all, let's just look at the obvious situations. When looking at stats in football, I don't like to use blanket stats like interceptions, blocks, or etc. because someone that plays in a much deeper team is going to have loads of interceptions, blocks, and etc. more than someone who plays in a high line. So I don't use that as a measuring stick. I'm going to use three statistics with three other right backs that people consider to be better defenders than Trent and prove to you that Trent actually can defend, and it's simply a myth perpetuated by a lot of people in the media sometimes, but mostly fan bases. Let's look at the first statistic. Tackle success. Now, tackle success has nothing to do with how high you play, the team you play for. Tackle success is you simply going in for the tackle and winning the tackle. Trent, tackle success, 57.9%. Walker, 54.3%. Trippier, 43.9%. Reece James, 38.8%. So, Trent Alexander-Arnold is more successful in a tackle than Kyle Walker, than Kieran Trippier, and then Reece James. Let's look at the next statistic. Dribbled pass per 90. Dribbled pass per 90 is a very simple stat that shows you how many times the player is likely to get dribbled past in the 90 minutes. Trent is the least likely person to get dribbled past per 90 minutes than the other three, who a lot of people consider to be better defensively. Trent has a 0.71 dribbled pass per 90 stat, while Walker has 0.74, Reece James has 1.14, and Kieran Trippier has 1.16. So he's less likely to get dribbled past than the other three as well. And finally, the one last stat I'm going to use for showing that Trent can actually defend, the ball recoveries per 90. Once again, so if someone actually gets past him, how likely is he to recover it? Trent has 9.97, Kieran Trippier has 8.87, Kyle Walker has 8.66, and Reece James has 8.18. So these three defensive statistics I've actually provided for you guys literally prove that Trent can defend, and as a matter of fact, defends better than these other three players I have mentioned that in the media and as perpetuated by a lot of fan bases defend better than Trent. Here's my problem with the Trent situation. If Trent Alexander-Arnold's name was actually Trentinho and he played for Barcelona and was Brazilian, every single one of you listening right now and everyone who says Trent can defend would literally own his shirt, would literally go around saying, oh my god, have you seen that Trentinho for Barcelona? He's incredible. But what you choose to do is you choose to be just like sheep and just, you know, regurgitate the BS people tell you that Trent can defend, Trent this, Trent that, when we all know he actually can defend. The problem is Trent is usually in a high line. So if I ask you right now, who is a better right back? Was it Dani Alves or was it Arbeloa? Because no one could look me right now in the face and tell me that Dani Alves was better defensively than Arbeloa. No one would argue that. Dani Alves himself probably won't argue that. Why do teams attack on Trent's side? It has nothing to do with Trent's defensive abilities, because Barcelona were always getting counterattacked on that Dani Alves side as well. So you need to look at the context and apply the context for every single player. So the reason teams attack down that Trent right-hand side is the same reason they attacked down that Dani Alves right-hand side when he played for Barcelona. Those two right-backs were actually so far up the pitch that the teams, that's just the obvious thing to do. You're going to attack where there's spaces. It has nothing to do with Trent's defensive ability or Dani Alves' defensive ability. We're just looking at teams' structures. Trent is the most creative player in that entire Liverpool team, and actually using the chances created stat is also the most creative player in the entirety of the Premier League. So when you look at the entire context and you look at individual statistics that show their abilities as defenders, you can see that Trent actually can defend. But Trent is usually so far high up the pitch that the other team has literally no other option but to attack that space on that right-hand side. Trent Alexander-Arnold is currently the best right-back on earth, and he's actually revolutionized the entire right-back position, as for the first time in history, Please just focus on what I'm saying. The first time in history, there's a right back who's the main creator in the team. Not a creator, I'm saying the main creator. The main creators have usually been number 10s, sometimes wingers, maybe possibly a number 8. But for Liverpool Football Club, and for the first time in history, we actually have a right back who is the main creator in the team. So just appreciate what you're watching. Once again, if his name was Trentinho and he played for Barcelona, you would all have his shirts and you would all call him the best right back on earth. Just because his name is Trent Alexander-Arnold and he plays for Liverpool, you want to find agendas to minimize him and to reduce his ability. Just enjoy what you're watching. We're watching a generational talent. He's already made the World 11 age 21. He's broke the Premier League records for assists, and then by a defender, obviously. And then the next season went back and broke his own record for Premier League assists by a defender. So people, respect what you're watching. Trent Alexander-Arnold actually runs games from that right back position.
If you have made it this far, thank you so much for sticking around. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, share the video around. And if you enjoyed the pre-recorded stuff, which we don't usually do, let me know in the comment section if you want me to cover any more topics. Thank you guys so much. Hit that notification bell so you join us when we go live.